Welcome back to the channel. In today's video, we're going to continue building the layout of our website. As you can see that we have the mock-up here, and then we also have what our site is starting to look at here. So if you missed the last video, please go check it out to see what we did to get to this stage. Now I'm basically going to lay out this with Bootstrap, and then eventually we're going to start adding in the little bits and pieces that are dynamic in terms of nature. For example, this is static code that is here, but we shall use the customizer to add this so that we can always quickly change it. It's not going to be so many words of text, so we'll use the customizer for that. And then we are going to use some dynamic placement of our products, whether they are variable or they are simple, and we'll put them in a pop-up that allows us to select a couple of things. The other thing that we'll do is have this mini cart showing up in the side. So if you want to see how we are laying this out, this is the video for you to watch. Let's start coding. From our previous video, we've been working on our frontpage.php file, and we've been working with the functions.php to enqueue the scripts, and we've done a couple of theme supports, and we've added things to our footer and to our header. So I'm going to continue with our header because we've not finished adding the logo in the right place, and of course from our sketch we've not added the help sign and also the login for our customers. So I'm going to start by doing that. So we already have a structure that is sort of similar with what we have here in the, with the orange background kind of thing. So we're going to lay out our logo right here just below this. We'll have our help button right here, and we shall have the login button also showing up here. I'm just going to duplicate this right under here so that we can use it. Then I'll make some real estate from my editor, and then what we're going to do is we had this sentence begin from here. We are going to cut our PHP that echoes our image, and then we are going to add it in this location. So I'll just do this, hit enter, and then I'll tab all of these to go in a level deeper. And I'll just clean this out, and then I'll save this. So once we've added our logo here, we have also a button that's showing up here, and we just need to add this little help statement showing up here. So I'm going to take away from this and make this 5, and then I'll duplicate this to make it 1, so that we have just one column. I'll close this div, and then inside here we're going to have our help. So I'll open a span and I'll call it help. Now of course our help is going to be leading somewhere, so it would be good for me to just add a link. So I'll add an href for this to work, and then I'm going to close this off. Now of course, I want the whole span to be clickable, so maybe I'll style it later, but I'm going to put it inside our HTML. Cut this, put it in here, makes sense for me to just add a pound sign. We'll make this dynamic a little later. So I'll save this header, come back here, reload, and you'll see we have this. Now this is with an orange background. We do not need that orange background, so all I need to do is just take this off, that CSS part that makes this orange, reload it. We have our button here, we have our logo, we have our help. Now we can individually streamline this to make the proportions correct, and we're just going to use CSS to do that. So I'll add some CSS to this and call it help button, and we have our logo here with the source, alt, and we can add a class logo image to it. So I'll call this image logo, save this, and then we shall go to our CSS and access that. So assets, CSS, go to this style. We're now going to add our image dash logo, and we need to also get our help button from there and add it to our style. So these are all individual classes. I'll add some things here. What we're going to do with the logo, we'll give it a width. We'll first of all display it as an inline block to allow it to have the properties of being inline and also the properties of being a block. So inline block, I'll give it a width of, let's just go back to our style here and look at this. So right now this has a width of 200. I'm just going to drop it a bit to 150 and then we'll allow the height to automatically do its thing. So I'll call this height and I'll say auto height, save this, and I'll come back and reload, and we see this is a little smaller and looking a little bit nicer. Now with our help, I'm going to use of course what we have here. So we know this call one spans all the way down and it's a flex element, and then we have of course our A tag here which is not flexible, it's not going all the way 100%. So I'm going to just come to this help button. So with our help button, we're going to come and display, we're going to help get our help button display flex, we are going to go for the width of 100%, and then after doing that we're going to also get the height of 100%, then we shall place items in the center, and of course we're going to be targeting the A tag, so we'll go back and reload our page. When we reload, you'll actually see that this A tag is going all the way 100% in terms of width and height, but when we go to the span, our span is only taking up the space that it needs to take up. So I just need to make that take up a space of 100% and then I'll be able to make it align in the center. So I'll go duplicate this help A, and then I'll target that span specifically, and I'm just going to say display block, and then I'm going to go for width 100, and then I'll just change this center to text align center, save this, come back here, reload, and you'll see that our help is actually in the middle and our A tag is actually filling up. So we have this in the center and that sort of makes us happy. Now I don't like this stay connected being here, I think it's misplaced with also this being right here. So what I'm going to do is just take away this stay connected, I'll come back here, look for this class, I'm going to take away this, we don't need it anymore, and then I'll just increase this by 2 and make this 8. So I'll save this, come back here, let's reload, and you'll see that that looks a little bit nicer than it was before. So we'll make a bit of those clean changes along the way as we lay out, but right now we need to get everything else stacked in as much as possible. So we have our logo, we have our help, we have our button, maybe I'll give this button our orange background, so copy it, come to our button here, save this, reload, yeah, that's orange as we need it. We'll do more along the way depending on how we want to refine all those pieces. Now let me put our image that we're going to need right here, and then I'll put in the next pieces. So remember we are using Bootstrap to do all of this. Now we can use this whole container fluid, so I'm going to copy this and then come to our front page here. I'm just going to add, close the PHP, open this PHP again, and then I'll paste this right here. I'll tab it in a little bit and allow us to do much more. So what I'm going to do is take out all these pieces because we don't need them. According to our design, we don't need anything in here. We just need to have our container fluid, then we shall put in our background image. So from here, I'm going to take this out as well. Now, do you remember that in our functions, we added support for a custom header? We can now go to our WordPress and just pick this code for the custom header and use that. So I'm going to come here, look for custom header on Google. We'll go, of course, to our handbook, the developer handbook. And in here, of course, you can see that you can add more details to the custom header by adding a default image, can add a default color, a width, a height, and so on. So what I want to do is just get this image and throw it on the front end. So all I need to do is just get this tag that we have here. So I'll copy this, come back to our front page, and I'm going to paste this here, and I'll just tab this right here. So you'll see that we have, if we're getting the source for the image as image header right here, we're also getting the width that we can describe by adding more properties to our theme support for the header. So you can add a flex width, you can add all these different things all together, and you can even add a default image so that when people install your theme, they are not automatically lost, but they get something that they can use. So we can adopt this and add it to our functions.php if we want to make it a little bit nicer. So let me also go and pick this up, and then we shall replace it with our custom header here. Of course, this will allow us to do much more. So for the width, I'm going to look for an image that's over 1200 in terms of size, and then the height, we're going to look for something that's about 300, allow a flex height and a flex width, and then in our directory, I'll add a header.jpg so that people can always start with something. So in our images, we just have only this file, which I used to show in our markdown, in our README file. Let me go to Unsplash, and I'm going to pick an image from there. So let's say maybe we want to get this bottle. I'll download this, that's above 1200. I'll save it on my computer, and I'm going to come and add it here inside images. So I've added this image in here, I'm just going to rename it. I'm going to rename it to header.jpg. It will remain like that. And then let's go to our front page, save this, come back to our front page, then try to reload this and see what happens. So we have an image right here that is supposed to be loading, but it's not loading. I'll click to inspect it, and we'll see that we have our image that's not showing up because we forgot to add the word assets right here. So I'll save this, I'll add assets, images, header, JPG, come back here and reload it. And you'll see that it automatically gets resized to a height of 300 and a width of 1200. So what I'm going to do is just add some CSS to make this look a little bit nicer. Of course, we want it to blow out and go full 100. So we need to add some CSS to that. I'll close off these other files, and then I'm going to come to container. So we're going to come to our image here, and we'll add a class of image fluid. Then we'll get this, take it to our style. Image fluid should just display or inline block, since we want to use also the properties of when it's inline. Then what we're going to do is we're going to choose to have this image and we want it to cover. So we're going to go for object fit, and we're going to choose cover in this particular case. So I'll save this, I'll come back here, reload this, and you'll see that our image is starting to look nicer. It's just fitting in the height that it's been given. However, it's not completely filling all the space that we need here. So what we want to do is actually we want to remove this margin right and left, the padding right and left, and just leave this to consume 100%. So with our container fluid, I'm just going to add and full width container, I'm going to copy this, of course save this, come back to our style, and then I'm going to make this modification to our bootstrap style. Now the reason I did not make this standalone is because I still want to use the benefits of bootstrap, but I can still modify it and make it easier for me to do. So what we want to do is actually we want to remove this margin right and left, the padding right and left, and just leave this to consume 100%. We want to make sure there is no padding, there is no margin to the right and left, and we want this to go full 100% all through. So we'll come back to our style here. We're going to say margin, and we're going to say 0. We don't want any margin on it. We don't want any padding, so we'll make that 0. We want it to go width 100%. Now, of course, we'll just add min dash width to make sure that it's always going to go 100%. So I'll come back here, reload what we have, and we'll see that our container is actually maximizing all the space. However, the image is not taking up all the space. And now we need to just get that image fluid and give it 100%. So I'll come here, copy this min 100%, and then drop it here, come back, reload, and our image is going all the way through as we wanted it to look like right here. So you can choose any other image, but this is the default image I wanted to have inside my default theme. Now, of course, you can have this image trimmed to make it more optimized. It doesn't have to be all full 100 here. So you can make it trimmed to 3, height of 300, and of course you want the width to stay above 1200 pixels, because that's what we stated in our functions with PHP, that that should be the minimum that we have of the image. Now, since we are using dynamic header here from WordPress, let me log in into the admin. So I'm going to come here, open my admin. This is a little app that I'm using to give me a local server. I'll log in here, and then I'm going to come to my customizer. So I'll go to appearance, go to customize, and you're going to see that we have header image in here. And of course, by default, we have this. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to hide this image, and then I'm going to put a completely new image. So let's say I wanted to use this pizza image. I can just click select and crop. Of course, if you want, you can crop it, but I'll skip the cropping for now. And then I'm just going to add this image right here, and it's taking up all the space. I'm going to publish this. Come back here to our front end, reload. Now, once this image is loaded, you're going to see that it's really huge, and you'll see that it's now going out of proportion, and we just need to do a couple of things to remove this. Now, first, I'll inspect this to show you where the problem is, and the problem is that this image is getting a width and a height, which are coming in from what we echo here. So we have a width, we have a height. So all I'm going to do is just come and take this out from here and save this. That's going to take away the problem of the height and the width. And then what we are going to do is come back here, reload this, and you'll see that we still have a bit of that problem, but we've taken away the width and the height. And now what we are going to do is come here, of course, add a height to our image fluid, add a height of 300 pixels, and I'm going to change this into a block style, and then I'll reload this here, and you'll see that now we no longer have the image running into the other side, but it's right in the middle. So let me try to change this again, so that we can see whether all images now will fit in irregardless. Remember, when you're making your particular theme, you have to make sure that everybody else can fit in irregardless of whatever image they come with. So I'll skip the cropping. So you'll see that even if this image was really tall, it automatically fits in here properly. So I'll hit publish on that, and then I'll leave the customizer, come back to the front end, and we have our image showing up properly right here. Now you can see there are small things that you can make changes to give this a nice feel, like add some padding right here. So that particular part is just coming to the header. Look at the code that we have here, and this should be in this particular place, and you can add some padding. That should be the padding top and the padding bottom. So what I'm going to do is come here to this, add a padding top of 5, and then add a padding bottom of 5. So I'll save this, come back, reload, and you see that it's really, really a lot. It's not what we are looking for. I'll just add maybe 2 to each padding bottom and padding top, and that's at least better than what we had before. So this is better, gives it a lot of breathing room. Now let's work on the next section, which is going to become really interesting. So I'm going to just skip this piece because we don't really need it, and then we'll just go next to our navigation tab here, and of course we're going to have our cut menu showing up there. So let me split up this here, and we're going to have just about 2 or 3 of what we have here. Now it will look better as the screen becomes wider, that will look better, but we also need to consider when screens are a little bit smaller. So that's where Bootstrap becomes a really good thing for us to look at. I'll close this inspector, and let's see, we have a proportion of about 7 to 3 if we are looking at 10, so 7 parts, and then 3. If we are looking at the 12 column grid, we have something here that's about 3 and 9. So let me do that. I'll copy what we have here, and then I'll come to our front page, come below, and then add this, and then I'll just tab it in to make it look a little bit pretty. We have, of course, our container fluid with some padding and bottom, padding at the top and the bottom. We have our row, we have the 2 from this side and the 2 that closes off. And then all we need to do is just have 12 minus 4 will give us 8, and we need to split this in a ratio that's a bit tricky. So I'll do 5, and I'm going to do 3, and I'll take out this middle piece. And right here, I'm just going to say mini cut, so that we know what's going to happen in the mini cut. And then in here, we're going to talk about having the navigation tab. So let me save this, come back here, reload it. You can't see so much of a difference, but I'll add the orange background here so that we can be able to see that a little bit clearer. So I'll reload, and you'll see that this is taking up nearly half the space, but when we blow out, then it becomes really, really, really huge. So I'll reduce this to about 2 and make this 6, and that will be a huge change. And you'll see that's at least a little bit more flexible to what we were having before. So if we want to get this, of course, we have to move it in a margin that's minus this particular mini cut. Then it will go all the way up and then down, and then we'll have our navigation right here. So let me go to Bootstrap, and we're going to go to the layout. We'll look for components, and we're going to look for the navs. And in the navs, I'm going to look for something that's very specific. We need to have this navigation tab that we see here changing with different things. So what I'm going to do is copy this code right here, come back to our editor, and I'm going to change this navigation to what we have here. Of course, I need to tab this in to make it a lot cleaner. Tab out the div. We have this div content going in, this UL going in, and then we'll have also these list items going in. So I'll save this, come back to our front end, reload our theme, and you'll see that we have these bits and pieces that are changing. The reason we can't see so much is because we don't have any particular content showing up here. So let me add to that. So I'll call this home, I'll call this profile, and I'll call this contact. Now these need to match up, these IDs need to match up what we have here in these different tabs, and we need to know which one is active and we need to know which one is inactive. So that's already added for us. I'll save this. So we don't have that kind of change. Now the reason we are having this not changing the tabs like we have it here is simply because we've not activated the JavaScript that is related with this particular screen. So I'm going to scroll down and then we're going to find the JavaScript that's attached to this. So you're looking at getting anything that is in the ID of your tab, like what we have here, and you're looking for the link A, so that whenever it's clicked, you prevent the default action, and then you're going to get its tab and you're going to show the tab. So I'm going to copy this JavaScript, which is basically jQuery, and I'm going to come to my code. I'll go in the footer for now, just to make sure that everything is working well. I'm going to go just before the body, and then I'll add this right here, and I need to wrap it inside my script tag. So I'll do script, its type is of a text slash JavaScript, and then I'll close this off. So I'll save this. Let's come back to our page, reload. I'll come back and inspect the page to see if we have any errors. Now I'm having quite issues with getting this to load from the server. The other side we still get this failing. I'm just going to get Bootstrap and then save it locally, and then I'll load it from my server. I'll download this. I'll go to the compiled CSS and JavaScript. I'll save this. And then I'm going to come back to my folder. And then we have CSS here. We have bootstrap.min.css. So I'm going to copy this and drop it in my CSS folder. And then I'm going to go back here and also get the JavaScript. And I'm going to look for the bundle.js.min, which is the minified version of our JavaScript. So once I've done that, we now have this available. I'm just going to go back inside our NQ in the functions, and I'm going to basically just change from what we have live here and then make it the local version. So I'll copy what I used here for the CSS and I'm going to change it for the JavaScript. So I'll use the stylesheet directory URI, go to assets, then go to JavaScript, which is JS. I'll cut this, go to JS, then go to bootstrap.bundle.min.js, which we have right here. And then I'm going to look for the CSS as well, which we have bootstrap.min.css there. I'll copy this all the way to assets, and I'm going to replace this to get to the CSS, and I'll save this, come back into my browser, reload that, and now you see we don't have those errors anymore. And when I click here, you'll see that our Bootstrap is actually working very well, and we have the navigation showing up, and that's all we needed. So sometimes you need to load those files from your local site instead of from a CDN. The advantages of using the CDN, because they deliver the content a lot faster, but if you have a good host, then that shouldn't be an issue. This is a very small file to load from your server. We have this working well. Now we need to just add the content dynamically in this section, and we'll be able to see it coming on the front end. So that's going to be the uphill task that we are going to take right now.